because I was in a class at one time, and, you know, I'm one of those people that I can figure out anything. And I've been around with all the technology that has come out from the computer, when it didn't have a hard drive, now that it has one, even the telephone systems. You know, I am just a technology person. And there's no piece of technology you can give me today that I can't figure out how to use without the user manual. I know everybody's not like that. But when I look at the community, when I look at the people, especially my community, I don't want to deal with the issue. I want to deal with the root cause of the problem. And I feel like my business model has a way to deal with the root cause of not only my community's problem, but communities across the globe. Whenever you live in a society where you have to have a job to make a living, and you don't have one, it's a thing called Maslow's Law of Hierarchy of Need takes over. If you don't have food and you don't have a roof over your head and clothes, you're gonna hit somebody in the head to get it. Because guess what? You got nothing to lose. And so when you live in a society like that, this is called poor. They're gonna be with us always. We've known that from the beginning of time. We need to make accommodation for them because the middle class cannot do what it needs to do unless the poor is taken care of. The wealthy actually need the middle class, who and the poor is an offspring of the middle class. So when you're talking about dealing with issues like I'm talking about with poverty, first of all, I'm teaching people a new way. I'm not saying go to school, get an education, get the best job. I'm saying your ideas are your wealth. Your ideas, better ways of doing things, things that we do every day. This is how everything came into being. The chair we're sitting in, the table we're leaning on, and probably a majority of them were developed through people with wealth watching their workers and say, oh, he does that like that. Let me create something, you know, like what he's doing. Now, why wouldn't that person who's doing it down here in the poor realm do it himself? Why? Because it costs you about $10,000 to protect something and make it yours. And then it's only worth something if you could get it promoted, to market it, to sell it. And so what I've done here is I have a patent pending e-business model that takes your idea from the idea to proving its value, to protecting it, to promoting it, and instead of costing you $10,000 to make a dollar on your idea, I'm going to give everybody who joins a membership that I'm going to set up the opportunity to do it for $100 a year. The way I'll be able to do it is twofold. First of all, it's the business model itself, and secondly, it's volumes of people. Now, what I'm doing right now, that's one wealth building. Everybody who comes in will one way or the other make money, whoever joins the group. Now, the goal is to cause you to make money by letting your money work for you at the phase where I'm at now. So my ownership business model, I could go to a bank and say, loan me some money to do this business model, okay? But what I've decided to do is to take a small group of people who are working and transition them to working for money. Now I say working because this would be a second income stream for you, because it's going to cost you something to get in. It's going to cost you something to take an ownership interest in my business model, okay? And what I'm going to do with what you're going to put in is take it to launch the business model to the world so I could provide all those services I just talked about to the world. And so at this point, my goal is to take a lot of people and make them millionaires, multi-millionaires, because people do not own businesses that are successful, that are funded and are successful without making money. And I'll give you an example. If within 2 years, everyone who gets on my owner's team will be making at least $20,000 a year, where I'm only asking them for either $1,200 if you want to pay it on a monthly basis, or $1,000 a year in order to get involved. The first 2 years, there's no payout because we're building a business. Everything that you pay in is going to go toward promoting the business model and bringing in all those individuals who we're going to help to promote their idea. And as a result, the company is going to be making money, and then in the third year, we'll start paying out to all the owners. The owners don't have to have ideas. All you have to do is have either $100 a month or $1,000 a year, and a couple of hours a month, because you want to monitor your baby, you want to monitor what you own. And my requirement is that you join with me on a conference call once a month, so we can talk about how the business is going, how we're progressing, how much money we're making, who is it that we're dealing with, and how can we perfect it and make it better and improve it? Because change is ever happening, and you always have to upgrade.
Ms. Pointer, and I'd like to invite you to have, I know you're going to be in many other places, but I'd like you to make this a place where we can put you as a part of this ecosystem over here. So because the open class that I think they're going to allow me to do here, we want to have you and Coach and Ms. Jackson. We want to have you guys and any other, and this young lady right here. We want to figure out the best ways to promote what you got, what you're doing.
And that's, you know,
and this young lady right here, and everybody, you know.
I'm here for social media with Cy Bonds.
But you're also here, we're going to. Yes, ma'am.
It's like I hear people tell me about their business, and I automatically get solutions for the issues that can help you to. And that's why I want to do this, because I'm working with entrepreneurs here. Everyone that becomes a part of this organization will become a millionaire through being a part of it or through what you'll do with what you bring to it. For instance, my sister has been proofreading my material for a while.
Linda, what was that? What was that move?
She has an idea for a new invention.
Hey, Linda, explain that move you just did right there.
I was just saying that the people that come in, they get to communicate with each other.
Yeah.
Everybody knows about everybody else
of us,
you know, and you get feedback from them
about
what you can do
wonderful.
To expand your business.
Awesome. Awesome.
I mean, it's not just that. You don't have to, you have an idea. If you have an idea, you don't have to worry about where am I going to get funding to deal with this. You don't have to worry about is it really a good one? Because we're going to show you what to do with that.
Well, let me ask, how does Ms. Jackson, how do you feel about, what's your opinion? What's your pickup on that?
Sounds great. Sounds like a great opportunity for people that don't really know the business world, because I just know the body and what I, you know, do to relieve the pain. But as far as the office works, the bookkeeping and, you know, the laws and stuff that I need to know, that's like, in the water, I don't know it. So it sounds really good opportunity for me. But the thing I'm thinking about is these classes are going to be in the daytime at this time.
Well, there's another lady who's here today, Betty. She's a legislator for a parent who's been like a legislator for the schools around here, and we're building her a block. And she said, "Sai, I can't be here today." So I said, forget her name, but I said, we're going to do another class. Yeah, so I'm going to try and build classes around the community. So I'll talk to you about when the best time. I need to talk to you about that, so maybe we can build a class around that time, because what you do is important. So we can. That's how we got to be flexible. Yeah, distro. I did. Yeah, that's really what I'm teaching, and most of the people are really going to benefit from that. But because they want an ecosystem here, Coach. They want us to. So what we're initiating here, it's needed all over the West Side. I mean, you know, this is, you know, we need to be talking about these issues of how to promote ourselves, as opposed to all these other conversations that we're having. This is a conversation that we need to be talking about.
And do you know who some of the biggest entrepreneurs are? Parents. Parents who bring their kids to school and they're at home, or they're not at home, but they're raising generations.
Well, John Porter.
And they figure out all kinds
John
of
Porter, and see, you're going to meet some of the brilliant brothers and sisters I've been working with over the years. John Porter says that what is the first business? The first business is a family. That's really the first business, you know. So we're gonna. But what I need you guys to do now